Hi friends, today we are going to see a new topic on how to actually implement a polyphase structure. So the polyphase structures are basically nothing but a decomposition of a given transfer function. So when I say polyphase, I mean to say decompose or decomposition of the transfer function. So I wanted to decompose the transfer function, and then when I decompose the transfer function, I get smaller transfer functions, and the smaller transfer functions will work efficiently and faster as compared to the direct form. So that's why polyphase is faster as compared to the direct form. Also, it gives a parallel path computation to us, so that I can apply smaller transfer functions I can take, and I can apply the input to all the input on each input, various filters are working and their output is summed up. So actually I have a band of filters or bank of filters, okay? In that way, polyphase is very much we can say an advantageous thing over the direct form. Now let us see how to draw a structure of a polyphase structure. So if we say I want to draw the structure, so there are basically two structures of polyphase. Okay, let us take for example a third order or a three level decomposition. So the polyphase filter or the polyphase structure is decomposed into three levels. Okay, so I can write my transfer function h of z, which is nothing but equal to summation, okay, let's say I going from 0 to m minus 1, okay, z raised to minus I, okay, and pi of z raised to m. This is which type? This is type 1 of polyphase structures. There are type 2 also, where I will have L minus M minus 1 total I will be running up to. Okay. Now, here for our case, it is M is equal to 3. So my transfer function will be H of Z equals to summation I going from 0 to 2. Okay. Z raised to minus I pi z raised to 3. Okay, now we will open up the summation, and my summation, when I open up, it becomes h of z equals to, okay, when I is equal to 0, I will get z raised to 0, then pi of z raised to 3. So I over here is 0, so p0 of 3 plus z1, okay, p1 of z raised to 3 plus z2, okay, here z minus 1 minus 2 because I is minus, okay, p of 2 z raised to 3. That's all, okay, because it is up to from z raised to 0, m is equal to 0 or I is equal to 0 to 2. Now how can I make this? I know these are smaller structures, okay, so I will have 3 polyphase polynomials, okay, which I write as p0 of z raised to 3, p1 of z raised to 3 and p2 of z raised to 3, okay. Now when I give input to the first one, we know that h of z is equal to y of z upon x of z, correct? Right? So what will be total y of z? I will write here my y of z. Okay. Then I will multiply this over this side. So now my equation becomes, this remains y of z, and I will bring this x of z and multiply throughout here. Okay, in this equation. So I am going to get z0, p0, z cube, xz. Then here x z and here also x of z. Correct? So now I know that if I'm inputting x of n, then this together will give me x of n itself. This will give me z inverse x of z. So if I convert it to n, or if apply n z inverse z transform, this becomes x of n. But because of z raised to minus 1, this becomes x of n minus 1, and this becomes x of n minus 2. Okay, so for the first sequence, I'm getting input directly as x of n, because there is only one multiplier, z raised to 0, which is 1. So I'm going to get p 0 raised to 3 multiplied by n. The next p1 z raised to 3 gets also an input x of n, but it is once delayed. So I have to introduce a delay. So I will introduce a delay, which is z raised to minus 1, and that I will give it to p1 of z. So now here my input goes as x of n minus 1. Okay. Next, when I say p2 of z raised to 3, that time x of z is multiplied by z raised to minus 2. So what I'll do, I'll delay this once more, and then I will give this input to the p2 of z raised to 3. Now they together are added. So I will have an adder. Which will be combination of p1z and p2z. The output will get into the adder, and then it will get added to p03. So output over here becomes, okay, now this when it comes over here, okay, when I see output at this stage, it becomes x of n minus 2 p2 z raised to 3, or in terms of z transform, if I write, this becomes z raised to minus 2 x of z p2 z raised to 3. Correct? Now here I have z raised to minus 1 x of z p1 z raised to 3. Correct? And here x of z p0 z raised to 3. Right? These are the outputs over after the p gain blocks. Now when I add these two over here, the output is, at this point the output is, at this stage I'm going to add these two guys, so output becomes z inverse x of z p1 z raised to 3 plus this one z raised to minus 2 x of z p2 z raised to 3. Correct? Now this signal gets an input over here and it will add with this guys. So finally I'm going to get, after this adder, I'll be achieving y of z. So at this stage I will get final input as xz, okay, p0 z raised to 3 plus this whole term. Okay, that is what the desired output is. So this is the way we normally make a polyphase structures. These are called as m components of polyphase structure. So I have considered now m is equal to 3, so I will have 3 total subsections. If l is equal, m is equal to, let's say, some 5, so I will have 5 subsections and respectively 5 delay blocks. Okay, so this is way we make a structure of a polyphase filter. Now we can interchange the positions of the delay and the adder. Okay, or not only the, not also the adders, but only the delay blocks, and we get a new type of a structure. That structure is called as a transpose structure. So transpose structure looks very similar to the normal structure. Only thing is the delay blocks have been changed as position. So now suppose I have input. Do I give P0 of Z now? Then I give input as P1 of, oh sorry, Z raised to 3. And then P2 of Z raised to 3. Okay. Again, this is my X of N. Now, at the output side, I will introduce a delay one time and I add them likewise. Okay. So now we have next is I'll add one more delay. Okay. One more delay, and finally that goes to an adder back, and that whole comes as an output y of n. Okay, now let us see stage by stage what will be the outputs. So the output over here, we get x of n as an inputs, x of n over here, x of n over here, and x of n over here. Okay, to that I now multiply with P03. This becomes x of n P03 raised to P0 is Z raised to 3. This becomes xn P1 Z raised to 3, and this becomes x of n P2 Z raised to 3. Okay, this is the output at the multi after the gain blocks. Now you are going to multiply this, or you are delaying this signal by 1. This polynomial is not going to get affected, but x of n will be getting delayed. Or if I write in the case of Z transform, then this stage the output will be xz z inverse P2 z raised to 3. Correct? Now this both are going to get added. So at this point the output comes as xz, this whole sequence I will write, P1 of z raised to 3 plus xz z inverse P2 of z raised to 3. Correct? Now the whole system will get a delay of 1 more time because I have z raised to minus 1. So at this stage, this one, I'm going to get xz. Now I don't have any delay over here, so it will get multiplied by z inverse P1 of z raised to 3 plus this whole stuff will be xz z raised to minus 2 p2 of z raised to 3, because here I was already having a delay. So when I multiply with this delay, it becomes twice. So that's why it becomes z raised to minus 2. And finally, this will get added with xz p0 of 3. So final y of n I can write as, okay, this signal first, which is xz p0 z raised to 3, okay, plus this whole stuff, that is xz z raised to minus 1 p1 of z raised to 3 plus xz z raised to minus 2 p2 of z raised to 3. So this is what the output, which you can see is very similar to the previous case. See here. So that really does not make any difference. So this is called as a normal structure, where the delay blocks are on the one side and the adder are on the other side, whereas we also have a transposed structure where the delay blocks and adders are in one line. So it is possible to either have a transposed structure or to have a normal structure. We will very soon see what are transposed structures and how we can use, and which in which system we should use transposed structures and in which system we should use the normal structures. So I hope you have understood how to actually implement a given polyphase structure. Thank you.